With the passing of Maryland Congressman Elijah Cummings yesterday, we heard from a lot of people from all over the country, really, including the President of the United States, weighing in on the contributions of this member of Congress, this member of the House of Delegates, once again, somebody like I said, I've known going back 40 years. And we did not hear, though, at least on air publicly, from the former governor of the state of Maryland from 2003 to 2007, but also somebody who served in the House of Representatives from the 2nd Congressional District while Congressman Cummings was from the 7th, former Maryland Governor Robert Ehrlich Jr., now a many-time author and a big-time attorney. How you doing there, Governor?
Hey, buddy. It was great being with you yesterday.
It really was. It was great catching up. It was great catching up. But I really wanted your voice, not just for this issue. I want to ask you about a couple of things with President Trump in a moment that are happening nationally. But just for a moment, as we were both doing yesterday, just reflect on Congressman Cummings, and not just him as an individual. But when you hear the talk about crossing over lines and working with people from different parties, that's what a lot of it came out. Not necessarily voting, but just the relationships with different people.
I guess I sound like a dinosaur, but that's okay. I guess we're two dinosaurs, me and you. We were not close friends, as you know. In fact, going back to the House of Delegates, we were always on different sides of an issue, and that continued in Congress. It continued during my governorship and all that. So we found ourselves almost always opposed because we came from very different philosophical viewpoints. You know that very well. And my point here is this. So we knew each other an awful long time, and we disagreed almost all the time on every major issue, and we found ourselves at odds. But it never got personal. It never crossed a line. It never led to either one of us taking the social media or talk radio or whatever and going over that line that used to be part of the political culture, both in Annapolis and in Washington, D.C. And somehow, some way, we needed to get back to that. There was mutual respect. We both had the same bottom line, obviously, moving the ball forward, helping the city of Baltimore, whatever it was, trade issue, budget, whatever it happened to be, it didn't matter. But people forget that. Today it's more warlike, and I hate war analogies, but it is more warlike, and I blame social media for depersonalizing this whole thing. So I have to say that Elijah and I, you know, whenever we saw each other, we greet each other. It was never that sort of antagonism that today you would come to expect from two politicians who disagreed on issues.
Former congressman, former delegate, and of course former governor, Bob Ehrlich is on the line with us right now. And Governor, you've been writing about some of this in some of your books about, you know, how we've kind of devolved in terms of our politics.
Yeah.
And one of the ways we've devolved, and I think it goes to the issue of, you know, Congressman Cummings and his district as well, is redistricting. We've created districts that have created, I believe, the type of toxicity in our politics, Governor.
Well, you and I have lectured on this. We've discussed this many times. And before I leave Congressman Cummings, I'll just say, whenever I think of someone, particularly passing, the first word that comes to mind, it's the first description that comes to my mind, and here was tenacious.
I hear you.
Is that fair?
Yes, very fair. Very fair. Very fair.
So, always. And that's a great compliment in politics. So your point about the redistricting practices of both parties, driven by the national parties to create safe districts through directives to the state parties, is very well taken. I've talked about this many times. I've written about it. You've talked about it. We've all bemoaned it. And for your listeners, what it really means is that once parties get a hold of a state legislature, and it's a long-term hold, such as Maryland on the left or maybe Texas on the right now, the pressure from the national parties down to the state party is to draw safe lines. We want that majority in the House of Representatives. Your job is to draw a safe line so that we can count on X number of seats from your state going forward. That's the game. That's the way the game was played. As you know, going back to my time in the House, they redrew me out of my district.
Amazing.
and put the Wayne Gilchrist and me in the same district because Ocean City and Timonium had so much in common, right?
Amazing, amazing.
And listen, the Democrats did it in Maryland. The Republicans do it to the Democrats in places like Texas and red states. It's a problem because the byproduct is, as you say, I love your word, toxicity. Toxicity. So what makes it so toxic is that when you have these safe seat members, they're more philosophically inclined. Not only more philosophically inclined, they're more apt to not compromise because
there's no benefit.
The pressure going to be on election day?
It's
not
going to
be the general election. It's going to be in the primary being challenged from the far left or the far right.
Exactly, Governor Bob Ehrlich. It has no benefit at all when a Congressman Elijah Cummings, and this is not to besmirch him at all, but when he's representing a district that is 90% Democrat, what does it benefit him to work with somebody from the other side? It doesn't.
It does, and as I said, what's happening now, particularly on the left, you see now progressives challenging liberals.
Exactly.
And you saw this not so recent past on the right, where maybe Tea Party folks would challenge sitting conservative Republicans in the House. Now you see it much more on the left, where someone's not liberal enough for a progressive district, so the progressives come up with their own candidate, and that liberal is now looking over his or her shoulder, worrying about the next primary, not the next general election. And that's what's happening. Liberals are being knocked off, and that's one of the reasons both the Maryland Democratic Party and the National Democratic Party have moved so far left so fast.
When it comes, Governor Bob Ehrlich, to the time that you were in Congress and you had people like Senator Mikulski, Senator Sarbanes, Elijah, and like I say, even though there were those battles that you got into, I mean, it was just maybe I'm being nostalgic. It was just a different time where it wasn't
we are really dinosaurs talking about this, but you and I both know that when I was governor, I was playing pickup basketball with members like yourself.
That's correct.
In Congress, the House gym used to be the only bipartisan place that there was. And Vice President Gore would come over and play basketball with us when I was in the House. We've lost this. And so today, what do people do? They spend their time going to Twitter.
Yep.
Or some other social media platform and doing their thing. And toxic is just the best term I can think of because it's descriptive of what's happening. And I'm not sure how we put that genie back in the box is the problem. People ask me this all the time. Well, you've identified the problem. What do you want to do about it? What can you do about it?